Hi, my name is Jason Kang. I'm a full-stack developer working in South Korea. Simply put, object-oriented programming means creating your own data types for your program. If you are a software engineer or a software developer, you're very likely to have heard about object-oriented programming. Sounds kind of fancy, but it's actually not that difficult. So let's break this down like we did with HTML and CSS. If you look into terminology, it really helps you understand what it really is. Just like the name says, object-oriented programming means that your program is organized with objects. And to understand what an object is, you gotta understand what a class is. A class is a way to define data. Let's think about a car. We're trying to define what a car is. There are a lot of properties of a car that comes to your mind. You can think about its make, its manufacturer, the model, the color, or types like sedan or SUV. These properties are called class attributes. A car is also capable of doing something. It can start, stop, or drive. These are called class methods. And if you use JavaScript, which is the programming language that we have been using to build our blog, you can declare a class called car like this. I have just defined a class called car. Then what's an object? An object is an instance of a class created with specific data. In English, it's an actual example of a class. Let's think about Tesla Model X. And if you were to declare the Tesla Model X object with the car class we just created, it looks like this. In the example that I just gave, the Tesla Model X is the object. So object-oriented programming is writing your program using objects and classes like we just did by defining your own data types. I said class is a data type because data types are also classes. When you think about a number 3, it may just look like a number. But in programming, the number is a class and the number 3 is an object. And just like the Model X object we created, number 3 also has its attributes and methods. For example, you can change the number 3 into a string by calling the toString method. And string is a data type that represents sequence of characters. If you think about our blog project, a blog post can be a class. And you can add attributes like the word count, title, content, the author, or the time that is written, and also add methods like write, edit, and delete. And each blog post that you write would be an object. And that's it for today. And as always, if you want to learn something specific, leave them in the comments below so I can answer your questions. Thank you, and stay tuned.